nice that you join this practice today. I'm going to keep it nice and slow. It doesn't matter. You don't need to do anything in it. See if you can really be aware of your body, of your own energy today, of your breath. We're going to dive a little bit deeper into the forward folds to calm down your mind, to just give yourself a nice slow practice starting your weekend. So just see if you can close your eyes for a moment. If you think you might need your books during your practice, just see if you can grab them now, and then just see if you can connect with your body. Taking a moment to tune in with yourself, arriving onto your mat. Be aware of how you feel. Notice everything that's happening within your body. See if you can sit up straight with a long spine, pressing, rooting your sitting bones into the earth, and then rise up. Through every vertebra, let your head just balance on top of your spine. Shoulders are soft, your face is relaxed. And then you can start to deepen your breath when you're ready for it. Make every in and exhalation a little bit longer, a little bit more intense. Just filling yourself up with new life energy on every inhalation. Feeling that you grow, creating space. When you exhale, you just release all the tension, everything you don't need anymore. Contract the back of your throat, creating a soft sound with your breath, activating your Ujjayi breath here. Just take one more deep in and exhale. And try to stay connected with this deep breath during your practice. When you're ready, you can slowly open your eyes. You can also keep them closed. Just change your legs. Bring the other leg forward or on top. Keep sitting up straight and then extend your arms all the way up to the ceiling. Interlace your fingers. Give yourself a nice stretch. And then you bring your left hand down, palm of your right hand faces towards you. Just gently move over to the left side. Keep your right sitting bone onto the floor, your neck is soft. See if you can keep using your in and exhales. If you want to, you can wiggle that right fingers a little bit, finding some more extension there. All the way from your right hip to your right fingertips. And then slowly come back up. Left arm rises. Gently move over to the other side. Make sure you keep both shoulders soft away from your ears. Try not to get as deep into your pose as possible, but see if you can find space Find length, releasing tension. Give your body the space to stretch out a little bit more by releasing. One more deep in and exhale. And come all the way back up. Then you bring your hands behind you for a moment. Maybe stay onto your fingertips. You can turn your fingers to the back. Just lift your heart up for a moment. Open your chest. Maybe you feel the opening of the ribs. And come back to the center, bringing your hands all the way forward. If you're sitting onto a block, remove it from under your sitting bones. Walk all the way forward onto your fingertips. Then take a deep inhale, lift your heart up. Sitting bones stay down, walk your fingers maybe a little bit more to the front. Your inhale, lift back up. And exhale, lower. Pull your navel in, fold your upper body over your feet. Deep inhale, lift up one more time. Walk maybe even a few centimeters more to the front. And then finally release your head. Feel the length into your arms, into your side body. Take a moment to set an intention for your practice today. Start to lift back with your heart. If you want to, you walk your hands forward. Roll all the way over your knees, coming onto hands and knees. And if you like to, you just make some circles here. Maybe you just like to do some cat-cow. See if you can open up. See if you can start to move with every vertebra in your spine. Maybe you like to move your hips. You can bring one arm up. See if you can listen to your body. Just notice what you need at this very moment. And then really gently come back to the center. Now from here, if you need to bring your knees a little bit wider, just walk your hands all the way forward for a moment into puppy pose or melting heart pose, sitting bones up to the ceiling. Give your arms, your side body a nice stretch, the whole front of your body. Make sure you still breathe. Gently pull yourself all the way back up. Walk your hands back under your shoulders. And then from here, bring your knees back under your hips if you brought your knees to the side. And then start with your left leg this time. See if you can bring your leg to the back. Push it away from you. Keep your knee facing down and slowly bring your knee to your nose. Round your spine. Press both hands in the floor. Slowly lengthen your leg to the back. And gently pull it all the way back. One more time, lengthening out. And slowly hug it in. Then from here, you bring your left foot all the way to the back. See if you can walk your left foot all the way over to the right side. But keep your hips on top of your right knee. You can look over your right shoulder towards your left foot. Pressing your left heel to the back. One more in an exhalation. And then you come back to the center. Bring your left knee down. Slowly bring your right leg to the back. See if you can lengthen the back of your leg completely. Deep inhale here. And then pull everything in round your spine. Make yourself small. Slowly stretching out. And hug it back in. Once more, lengthening. And gently hug it in. Then from here, you stretch your right leg all the way to the back, toes onto the floor. Then walk that right foot to the left side. See if you can keep hugging your inner thighs towards each other. You can look over your left shoulder. Make sure you're not collapsing into your shoulders. Keep your navel pulling in a little. One more in exhalation here. And then come back to the center. Bring your knee back down. And then you come all the way onto your knees. You can bring your right foot all the way to the side. See if you can stay on top of your left leg. And bring your right hand on top of your right leg. Bring your left arm all the way over. Just give yourself a nice side stretch. Make sure you keep pressing your right foot into the floor. If you prefer to bring your hand behind your head, just go for it. Staying here for one more in an exhale. And come all the way back up. Gently bring your arm down, bring your knee back. Lengthen that other leg to the side. Keep your toes of your left foot facing forward. Hips on top of your right leg. And then slowly move over to the other side. Just keep it nice and easy. Try not to go forward, but really to the side. If you brought your hand behind your back, go for it. Keep lifting your chest all the way up. Try not to round, pressing your right knee down. One more in an exhale. And come back to the center. Knee comes back down to the floor. Come all the way back onto hands and knees so you can tuck your toes under and rise up into your first down dog. A few breaths here. Maybe you like to walk your dog. Maybe you can bend your knees and bring your whole upper body into your thighs. From there, you walk your dog or move your hips. Start to find a length all the way from your feet to your sitting bones. Your sitting bones to your hands, that's even more important. Lengthen through your arms, lengthen through your side body. Sitting bones press up and away. When you're ready, you come to stillness in down dog. Spread your fingers wide. Make sure you keep your upper arms rotating away from your ears. Space for your neck. Taking one more deep in an exhalation into your downward dog. And see if you can walk your feet really slowly. In really small steps all the way to the front of your mat. Maybe first your heel, then the ball of your foot, and then your toes. When your feet are all the way forward, see if you can wrap your arms around your legs. Maybe you need to bend your knees, fold your upper body over your thighs, and bow all the way forward. If you have the space, maybe you cross your hands in front of your ankles. Keep pulling your inner thighs together a little bit. Try not to overstretch your legs. If you are flexible, keep pulling your sitting bones together a little bit. Up into the sky. Navel keeps pulling in. One more deep in an exhale. And then release your arms. Very slowly start to come up. Take your time, your head comes up last. When you're up into a standing position, you bring your feet together. Hands come all the way in front of your heart center. Feel the length, feel the center of your body. When your next inhalation, circle all the way up, stretch yourself out. When your exhalation, bow down from your hips, long line. Half lift on your inhalation, flat spine. And on your exhale, step your feet into a high plank. slowly shifting your weight a little bit forward, knees down, chin and chest just above the floor. And then roll forward into easy baby cobra. Slowly going down, tuck your toes under and make your way back into down dog. A few breaths here. You can always move a little bit if you like to. Maybe you just enjoy the stillness, observing your body within. Coming back to your breath. One more deep in and exhalation. And then look in between your hands, soften your knees. See if you can take a big step forward. Half lift on your inhalation. And on your exhale, bow down. Deep inhale, rise up. Exhale, bring your hands back in front of your heart center. Deep inhale, rise back up. And exhale, fold down. Half lift on your inhalation. And your exhale, step your feet back into a high plank. Wait a little bit forward. You can bring your knees, chin and chest down, or you come into low plank, chaturanga. Forward into cobra. And back in down dog. A few in and exhalations here. Really feel that you keep pulling everything up to the center. Don't let anything pop out. Your belly pulling in a little bit. Press your hands deep into the earth. Root your feet down. One more in and exhale. Look in between your hands, soften your knees, and step, or maybe you float to the front of your mat. Half lift on your inhalation, and exhale, bow down. Lengthen all the way back up, and bring your hands back in front of your heart. Last time, take a deep inhale, rising, and exhale, bow forward. And you can keep your hands flat when you lift your heart forward and up. And exhale, step or hop into your plank. Cobra or up dog. And come back into downward facing dog. And from here you can start to bring your right leg up. Just hold it for a moment. Make sure you keep your upper body nice and long in one line with your arms. If you need to, you can always bend your standing leg a little bit. Keep your knee pointing down to the floor. One more deep inhalation here. And then pull your knee to your nose, come high onto your left toes. Slowly rising back up, stretch it out. And knee back, round your spine, squeeze your navel in. And lengthen all the way back up. Last time, knee to your chest, looking between your hands. With softness, step your foot all the way forward. And then from here, you let your left knee come down to the floor. Slowly bring your arms up. Try to keep them next to your ears. Just move from your hips coming up. Pull your navel in. And gently let your hips melt forward. Open up your hip flexors. Slowly rise up. Keep your hips next to each other. And melt forward. One more time. Lengthen up. And exhale. Slowly sink down. And then from here, you come all the way up. Bring your hands next to your right foot. Extend your right leg out. Maybe you bring your hands onto your blocks. Take a deep inhale. Lift your heart. And exhale, bow forward. Deep inhale, lift up. And exhale, bow down. Keep the length. Two more. Deep inhale, lengthen even more. Exhale, press that sitting bones back. Pull your navel in. One more time, lengthen. And exhale, slowly lower. And bring your heart back up. Bring your right foot onto the floor, tuck your left toes under, extend your left leg out. Maybe you keep your blocks underneath your hands. Deep inhale here. And exhale, pull yourself all the way up. Lengthen your legs. Maybe you lift your right toes off the floor. Come back. Bend your right knee. And lift your hips up. Maybe you pull your toes towards you. Two more. Bend your right knee. Keep your left leg nice and long. And slowly hug your hips up to the ceiling. Last time, lengthen the left leg, open your heart a little, and pull everything up. Then you come back onto your right foot, left hand down. Open that right arm, keep your hips nice and low, strong legs. Keep spreading your shoulders, pull your navel in. And then bring your right hand down. Step your right foot next to your left. And slowly go through your vinyasa from here. Do it with control, with awareness. Choose your own options. Maybe you need to work a little bit on your chaturanga. Take your time. Bring your all the way back into down dog. Slowly bring your left leg up. Not too high, squared hips. Keep pressing your weight to the back, like you bring all the weight away from your hands, only into that right foot. Shooting the energy through your left foot. One more deep inhale. And then pull your knee all the way to your nose, round your back. Deep inhale, extend back up, lengthen out. And drag everything back in. Last time, lengthen up, pull it in, step your foot all the way forward, and then bring your right knee down, slowly lengthening your arms, then shift your weight back, coming all the way forward, keep using your in and exhalations, lengthen and rise, and slowly lower, two more, lift yourself up. Pull through the middle, and exhale, release. Last time, lift up, and come all the way forward. You can come on to your right knee, bring your hands down under your shoulders, extend your left leg out. Maybe you use your blocks, deep inhale, lengthen, sitting bones back, heart forward, and exhale, bow down from your hips. Deep inhale, lift up. And exhale, bend forward. Keep pulling your toes towards you. Two more, lengthening and lifting. And gently bow forward. Last time, lengthen up. And slowly lower. Lifting your heart back up from there. Bring your foot onto the floor, hands next to your left foot. Extend your right leg out. Lift your heart up. And exhale, push your hips up, shift your weight maybe a little bit to the back. Slowly bend your left leg again, open your chest, and push your hips up, squeeze your inner thighs together. Slowly lift your heart, and exhale, bow down. Last time, lengthen your heart up, keep pressing your right hip back, and slowly bend forward. And then from here you come back, bring your right hand at the inside of your left foot, squeeze your inner thighs together a little bit more, open your left arm on top of your right. Try to keep squeezing in through the midline. One more deep inhale, and then bring your hand down, step back into plank, slowly make your way to your own vinyasa. Back in down dog. Coming back to your breath here. One more in an exhalation. Look in between your hands, soften your knees, and step or flow to the front of your mat. From here, you can bring your feet hip width apart, right hand underneath your chest and slowly lengthen that left arm up. Make sure you're not going to hang, also not round, so you can keep extending your whole spine, twisting with your whole spine here, keep your sitting bones back. And slowly change sides, left hand under your chest, bend your left knee, extend your right leg out. Nice twist to the other side. Just for one more inhale, lengthen it out even more. And then bring your head all the way down. Now slowly bend your knees. See if you can interlace your fingers behind your back. Stretch your arms away from you, lift your chest. Just deepen a little bit here. Feel that you want to fold your upper body already over your legs and lay your bow all the way down. Maybe you keep a little bend into your knees. Relax your head. See if you can really use gravity. Maybe you like to shift your weight just a little from side to side. One more of your deepest in and exhales. And then slowly release your arms. Rise all the way up. And then bow forward, hands next to your feet. Half lift on your inhalation. And slowly step, maybe you hop back. Gently going through the rest of your vinyasa. Meeting back into down dog. When you're in downward dog, you can bring your feet together, lift your right leg up, and you open your right hip on top of your left, bend your knee. See if you can come onto the fingertips of your left hand, keeping your shoulders aligned. See if you can just open up that right hip, not going to hang into your upper body or into your shoulders. One more deep in an exhalation. And then you can bring your knee all the way to your chest. Softly step forward. Then turn your left heel down, rise all the way up. Warrior two pose. Now extend your legs, extend your arms, bring your gaze up to your thumbs. And slowly open. Deep inhale, rise up. And exhale, open it up. One more time, lengthen and lift, and open, deepen into your legs, bringing your right arm forward, lift up and over into reverse warrior, just for one deep inhalation, stretching out, and exhale, come to the center, right arm reaches forward, you can bring your elbow onto your thigh, left arm over your head, or you bring your right hand at the inside or at the outside of your right foot. Keep lengthening. Don't let your upper body drop forward. See if you can gaze underneath your arms up into the sky. Keep pressing your right leg into your arm. Staying here for one more deep inhale. And then slowly look down. Bring your left hand on your hip. Maybe you make your step a little bit smaller. You can use your block. Bring your weight onto your right leg. See if you can keep a long line all the way from your head to your left foot. Stacking your hips, your shoulders on top of each other. Maybe you extend your left arm up and you gaze up. See if you can keep your weight a little bit forward into your right foot. Into the toes of your right foot actually. One more deep inhale here, and then look down, bend your standing leg, take a big step back. And from here you circle your arms at the inside of your right leg, move from side to side. So you can go really close to the floor, keeping your feet down, giving yourself a nice stretch at your inner thighs. If you want to, you can add your arms, whatever feels good. And then you can come all the way to the front of your mat. Walking your right foot out a little bit. down onto the floor. Maybe you keep your left leg long. Then take a deep inhale, lift your chest up. And exhale, bend your elbows. Maybe you kiss the floor. Deep inhale, lift back up. And exhale, lower. One more time, rise up. And exhale, bend down. Then you come back to the center. Maybe you bring your elbows onto the floor. If you have your knee off the floor, maybe you shift your weight a little bit from the front to the back. If your knee's down, maybe you'd like to move a little bit from side to side. Maybe you do it both. It's a different thing that you're noticing then. Keep your heart and your head lifted. One more deep breath here. And then slowly bring your hands back under your shoulders. Left knee comes down to the floor and come all the way onto your left leg. Walk your right foot back to the center, lifting your heart up. And exhale, bow down into Ardha Hanumanasana. If you like to, you stay here. If you are practicing your full split, slowly come forward. Make sure you're not going to hang into your pose. Keep putting yourself up a little bit. If you like to, as we do forward folds, you can bow down here over your right thigh. You are all the way into your full splits. Bring your hands back under your shoulders. Slowly drag yourself back into Ardha Hanumanasana. And then from here, you pull your right leg back. Hands under your shoulders, tuck your left toes under. Lift all the way up into a one-legged down dog. And then maybe you go through a one-legged vinyasa. Maybe just on 2 feet, that's fine too. See if you can do what feels good for you now. Bringing yourself back to down dog. Taking a deep in and exhale here. And then we go for the other side, feet together. Left leg rises. Bend your left knee, open your hip. Maybe you can come onto the fingertips of your right hand. Squeeze your heel to your sitting bone. Keep them facing up. Feel that you really press the floor away with your hands. One more in an exhalation. And then slowly pull your knee to your chest. Softly step forward. And then open up into warrior two here. Your next inhalation, lengthen all the way out. Maybe you look up and bend your left knee, deepen. Deep inhale, pull up through the midline. And exhale, slowly open. One more time, lengthen all the way up. And slowly open it up. Forward, up and over into your reverse warrior. Just for one deep breath in. And come back to the center. Lengthening to the other side. Elbow onto your thigh. Right arm over your head. Maybe you come into the variation you did at the other side. Just make sure your left knee is not falling inwards. Your hips are not popping up. You keep that long line of energy. Keep pressing, reaching in all directions. At the same time, keep your body soft by breathing deeply. No tension in your face. One more deep inhale here. Then circle your hand down. Bring your right hand onto your right hip. Make your step a little bit smaller. First, we go into Ardha Chandrasana, half moon pose. Use your block if you need it. Stack everything on top of each other. And see if you can find your balance up here. Keep your weight a little bit forward. Keep reaching through that right foot, through the crown of your head. just for one more deep inhalation. And then you look down, bend your standing leg, and take a big step back. Now circle your arms at the inside. Come back close to the floor. Keep your feet flat onto the mat. Maybe you like to add your arms in any nice position. And then you come all the way to the front of your mat. Walk your left foot out. And you can stay here. Maybe you bring your right knee down. Deep inhale. Exhale. Bend only your elbows. Kiss the mat. Lift yourself back up. And slowly bow down. One more time. Rise up. And bend forward. Come back on your hands, maybe you come onto your elbows, knee stays off the floor, or you bring it down. If it's down, wiggle from side to side, otherwise maybe a little bit to the front and to the back. Staying where you are for one more in an exhalation. First, bring your hands back down under your shoulders, knee down onto the floor if it isn't there yet. And bring your hips on top of your right leg. Left leg lengthens, hands under your shoulders. Deep inhale and bend forward into your half splits. Maybe you come up and you come all the way into your full splits. Not to move over to that left side. Keep pulling yourself away from the floor, squeezing your inner legs. Maybe you like to bend forward for a moment. Wherever you are, feel your breath flowing through your body. Find space on every inhalation. Soften a little bit more on your exhale. Your full split, slowly bring your hands back, gently pull yourself back up. And then from here, you can lift your heart up, drag that left leg to the back, hands on the floor, tuck your right toes under, one legged down dog. And then go to your own vinyasa on one or on two legs. Back into your downward dog from here. Deep in and exhales. When you're ready, you can bring your right leg all the way up. Slowly bring your knee to your chest. And with softness, you step your foot all the way forward. And turn your left heel down, come all the way up. Back into second warrior. And then extend your right leg out. You can make your step a little bit smaller for triangle if you like. And then lengthen up and over. Reverse triangle pose. Just for one deep breath, don't collapse. And come all the way back up. Extending all the way to the front. Don't stick your sitting bones to the back. Keep lengthening over your right leg. Bring your right hand in front of your ankle or your shin. Left arm up. If you have the space, maybe you grab your big toe. Just don't lose that line from the side. Keep hugging your inner thighs together a little bit. Squeeze your feet in the direction of the center. Feel that you keep pulling in through the center of your body. Taking one more in and exhalation here. And then you look down to your right foot. Lift your upper body up. Turn your right toes to the long side of your mat. And then bring your hands on your hips. Toes a little bit inwards. Gently come halfway forward. Hands under your shoulders. And then slowly walk your hands back. to, you can always get into your tribal headstand easily from here if you're practicing it. Sometimes you have these days that you're not going to get upside down like I have. So do whatever feels good for you today at this very moment. When you are all the way into your tribal headstand, gently bring your legs back to the sides, all the way down to the floor. And when you're down, you start to walk your hands back under your shoulders. Hands come back onto your hips, and then rise up with a long spine. And from here, you turn your heels inwards, bend your knees deeply, and then see if you can press your hands into your knees. Press your knees to the outside, then come onto the toes of your right foot and onto the toes of your left foot. Keep pushing your knees away. Right heel down, left heel down. Left heel comes up. Right foot off the floor. Slowly bring that left foot down and your right. Come all the way into the toes of both feet. Keep pushing your upper body out of your hips, your knees to the sides. One more deep breath. And then bring your heels down. Really slowly extend your legs out. And turn your left toe, both toes to the front of your mat. Both feet to the front of your mat. Make sure both heels are down. Both legs are as long as you can. Hips are squared. And then bring your left arm up. Left hand comes in between your shoulder blades. Right arm to the back. Maybe you can grab your fingers. Maybe you don't grab anything. You just open up your shoulders. Put your navel in. Lift your heart up. And slowly dive forward over that right leg. Keep pulling your right hip to the back. Lengthening the crown of your head in the direction of your right foot, your right toes. Keep your neck long. Just for one more deep in and exhale. And then you lift your heart halfway up. Bend your right leg. See if you can find your balance. You extend your standing leg as well. Variation of warrior three. And then you come all the way up. Release your hands. Hug your knee to your chest. Then from here you can bring your right hand on top onto your hip. See if you can grab your keep grabbing your left leg. Or maybe you can bring your hand at the inside of your leg and you grab your heel. Keep lifting up. Maybe this is enough for you. Maybe you extend your leg all the way out. If you like to, you lengthen your arm to the side. Give yourself a nice stretch at your inner thigh, but also a nice balance. Keep pulling up through that right thigh. Just for one more in an exhale. And then you bend your leg again. Place your foot at the inside of your thigh. Hands can come in front of your heart from here. Keep pulling through the center. Maybe you lengthen your arms up. Slowly taking one more in an exhalation. And bring your hands in front of your heart again. Left knee comes forward. Take a big step back with your left foot. Lift your heart. And slowly circle down. Step back. Maybe into a one-legged high plank or on 2 feet. And make your way back to down dog. Take a deep in and exhale here. Then you bring your left leg up. Slowly hug your knee to your chest. Step your foot forward and open back into warrior two. Lengthen your left leg. Maybe you walk the right foot slightly inwards. Keep your hips, your inner thighs pulling together. And then lift up and over. Reverse triangle. And come all the way back up. All the way to the other side. Keep lengthening out. And then you bring your hand in front of your your shin, other arm stacked on top. Maybe you can grab your big toe. Make sure you're not going to pop to the front. Keep extending out to the side. Hug your inner legs together. Just for one more deep inhale. And then look down to your left foot. Lift your upper body back up. Turn your left toes to the front of your mat. Hands back on your hips. And then from here, come halfway forward again. Now see if you can grab your big toes this time with your middle finger, your index finger, and your thumb. Keep your knees soft, your weight a little bit forward. Deep inhale and exhale, lower elbows to the sides. Try to pull your shoulder blades away from each other. Press your toes into your fingers. And at the same time, you want to keep dragging your toes off the floor with these fingers. Really feel the strength. Front of your head reaches down. Keep your neck long, sitting bones up. One more deep in and exhalation here. And then you come halfway up. Bring your hands back on your hips. Coming up with a long spine. And then from here, you turn your heels back in. Bend your knees. This time, bring your hands back onto your knees with just a nice twist. Deep inhale, lengthen. Exhale, one, shoulder to the front. Look over the back shoulder, upper body forward. Rising all the way back up. And twist to the other side. Rising back up. And slowly twist. Last time, lifting up. And twist to the other side. Then you come back to the center. Gently lengthen your legs. Turn your toes, your hips to the front of your mat. This time you bring your right arm up. And in between your shoulder blades, your elbow close. Other hand behind your back. And you can grab your fingers. Keep your navel pulling in. Hug your inner legs together. Lift your heart. And start to bend forward. Left sitting bone is pushing up and away. Keep engaging your inner thighs. Lengthen to your upper body. Maybe you don't come too deep. Just staying here for one more deep breath. And then you come halfway up. Bend your left leg. Shift your weight onto that left foot. Maybe you extend your left leg out. Keep your hips aligned. And slowly, slowly rise up. Releasing your hands. Give your knees a nice hug. Relax that lower back. And then from here, you can bring your left hand on your hip. Grab your heel from the inside if that works. Maybe it's just your ankle. You can stay here if it's enough. Maybe you can lengthen your leg a little bit or all the way to the side. Keep pushing it to the side. If you like to, you lift your left arm up. Keep lengthening through the crown of your head. Just for one more in an exhalation. And then bring your right foot at the inside of your left thigh. Let's come back in front of your heart. Take a moment into tree pose. Maybe your arms rise up. More in an exhale here, and then bring your hands back, slowly turn your knee forward, take a big step back, coming into your lunge, and then slowly go to your last vinyasa, on one or on 2 feet, back into down dog, and then you can look in between your hands, step or hop into a cross-legged position. From here, you can gently start to bring your left leg forward. Right foot comes at the inside of your left thigh. Make sure you have some space for your sitting bones. Lengthen your arms up. And then see if you can bow all the way forward. Surya Nrsimhasana. Maybe you grab your ankle, maybe your foot, you can even wrap your arms around your foot. Let that right knee just relax down to the floor. See if you can keep your heart reaching in the direction of your left leg. One more breath. Slowly starting to lift yourself all the way back up. Turn your right knee up. See if you can grab the sole of your right foot or your ankle, maybe your calf. Maybe you interlace all your fingers and then stretch your leg up. See if you can keep lifting through your heart. Maybe shift your weight a little bit to the back. Try to keep opening up your chest to the sun. You can pull that leg even closer. If you like to, you kiss your own shin. One more in and exhalation here. And then really gently bring your foot back. Now turn yourself all the way to the side. Bring your right knee to the side. Make sure both sitting bones are down. Maybe you like to sit onto a block. And then from here you can maybe bring your left hand to your left ankle or to your hip. Slowly opening that right arm up and over to the side. See if you can take an easy side stretch. Maybe you bring your hand behind the back of your skull here as well. Keep pressing that right sitting bone down. See if you can keep lengthening. Make sure you breathe nice and deep. Breathe into the tight parts of your body. Just for one more in and exhalation. And then rise all the way up. Really slowly bringing your knee back. Lengthen your leg back to the front. And then we go for the other side. Left foot comes at the inside of your right thigh. Space for your sitting bones. Keep your hips in one line. You can bring your arms up and bow all the way forward over your right leg. Keep your chest in the direction of your right leg. Not with your whole body next to your leg, but really a little twist towards your right thigh. Folding your upper body over that right leg. Keep reaching the crown of your head in the direction of your foot. Maybe you pull your toes a little bit closer. Staying here for one more deep breath. And then you rise all the way back up. Left knee comes up. Maybe you hug it close for a moment. Lengthen your spine here. You can come back into your variation. Maybe you grab your foot, your calf, or your ankle. You can interlace your fingers. Stretch your leg out. Keep lengthening from your lower back. Really feel that you press your sitting bones deep into the earth. You press your foot away up into the sky, the crown of your head too. If you like to, you pull your leg a little bit closer, but keep the length. Just stay where you are for one more deep breath. And then gently bring your leg back. Now slowly bring your foot back down onto the floor, knee back to the side, and then open that knee to the side of your mat. Make sure both sitting bones are down into the floor. Your legs don't need to be spread really wide. You can bring your right hand to the left side, extending your left arm up and over. You can keep pushing your sitting bones both into the floor. Maybe you bring your hand behind the back of your skull. Keep lengthening through that left elbow then. Just see what works for you. Make sure you're not going to bend forward wherever you're going. and slowly rise all the way back up. And then gently bring your left leg back up and then your leg to the front. Now, as we just have a few minutes left, we're going to end the practice. If you like to, you can always go into your forward fold from here, doing any stretches you like. Go a little bit further and end your own practice the way you like to. You can get into shoulder stand, into a headstand, do whatever feels good. So you did everything you like to do. Otherwise, you can slowly come onto your back. See if you can bring your knees to your chest. Have them close for a moment. And then extend your left leg down. Again, hop your hips a little bit to the right. And bring your right knee to the left. Getting into an easy reclining twist. If you have the space, you lengthen your leg out. You catch your foot. Maybe you bring your left foot to your sitting bone and catch it behind you. Just make sure your stretch is a relaxing pose. Giving some space to every vertebrae in your spine. One more deep breath here. And then come back to the center. Just center your spine for a moment. Maybe you hug your knees close. And then bring your right leg down. Maybe you bring your hips a little bit to the left and twist to the other side. Let's see if you can take the same variation. If you lengthen your leg, just stretch it out. Maybe you bend that right leg. Make sure you keep your right thigh in one line with your upper body. Maybe this is too much. If it's not a relaxing pose anymore, back up. Taking one more deep breath here. And then come back to the center. And then you can start to come all the way into Shavasana for a couple of minutes. Just stay there as long as you like. Maybe you start with taking a few breaths out. Relax completely. Make sure you stay there for at least 2 minutes. When you are ready for it, you come back into an easy seated position. Stay there for a moment with your eyes closed, just noticing what your practice did for you today. Just how you're doing, maybe coming back to your intention. And then you bring your hands in front of your heart center. Take a deep inhale here. And you exhale, bow your head to your own heart. Thank yourself for your practice. Coming all the way back up, opening your eyes. Namaste.